La notion de service écosystémique
notion of ecosystemic service is absolutely essential when talking about conservation of biodiversity. What is an ecosystemic service? It is a benefit given by ecosystems to mankind. The Millennium Ecosystem Assessment, a world expertise to which more than 1,000 scientists participated, in 2005 standardized the notion of ecosystemic service, acknowledging the existence of 24 major services, but what we're going to focus on today are the four main categories in which they have been classified. The four categories represent social stakes and biophysical stakes, which can be very variable. The one we are most interested in regarding biodiversity conservation is anything that has to do with environmental regulation and supporting services. Supporting services are at the basis of the function of ecosystems, and environmental regulation are all the services regulating ecosystem functioning. Ecosystem regulation, I will give you three examples. The first one is the climate regulation. Forests, wet areas store carbon, and because they store carbon, they mitigate global warming. Forests, wet areas, and oceans absorb 40% of the greenhouse effect gas emissions. Without this absorption, the climate would be warming up much more quickly. Through carbon storage, forests, tropical forests, which are threatened by the extension of a certain type of agriculture, play an absolutely essential role, something which is vital for human societies because they regulate the climate. Another ecosystem service are wet areas. Wet areas were considered as hostile environments, hostile for human societies, because those areas were not suitable for agriculture, possibly carried diseases, but because of the ecosystemic service notion, we now are changing our vision on wet areas, wetland. These wetlands are no longer hostile, but now we are beginning to understand that they are beneficial because they store carbon, they purify water, they hold and retain nitrates and polluting agents. We now are trying to protect them because we find them useful. Another ecosystemic service is pollination. For many years, people didn't worry about pollination. We now understand that it's essential for a number of cultures, and it allows to maintain plant spaces. 90% of plant species are pollinated by insects. Unfortunately, we didn't care for pollinating insects, and pollination has disappeared from some ecosystems. In China, for instance, in some types of agricultural production, agricultures and farmers have to replace pollinating insects that have disappeared. It means a lot of work, a lot of labor replacing pollinator insects. A third type of ecosystemic service is provided by biological control. What is biological control? Species which feed on pests, birds, bats, or parasitoid insects, insects which are carnivorous and feed on other species of insects which are pests for our cultures. Several ecosystemic services which are intimately bound with biodiversity, and biodiversity is also essential for the preservation of ecosystemic services. With the notion of ecosystemic service, we have one difficulty. There are two categories which are socially well known and have been preserved for a long time: cultural services such as gardens, beautiful landscapes, touristic landscapes, which have a cultural and economic value and have been protected for years because they are useful. We also have provisioning services, supply services, agriculture, fishing, anything that provides food and drinkable water. One problem raised by the notion of ecosystemic services is the arbitration, the choices we need to make between all of these ecosystemic services.
La figure suivante,
the next graph
la figure suivante, c'est
shows
qu'en fait, il existe une dialectique
that there is a dialectic relationship between the provisioning services and regulation services. The MEA has observed that over the last few decades, we have observed an improvement in provisioning services, agriculture, is more efficient, we produce more calories per capita. However, if we look at regulation services, we find that these services are declining and deteriorating. Now, trouble is, supply services also depend on the good functioning of ecosystems and therefore regulating systems or services. There are two possible scenarios here. One scenario in which we just keep going, but we can't keep going the way we are functioning right now. There will come a time when the degradation of the regulating services will be such that we will end up with a catastrophe and supply services will no longer be preserved because ecosystem functionalities will have disappeared. In China, we have a few cases, few examples where ecosystem functionalities are beginning to be seriously altered. The other scenario would consist in moderating our requests for supply services, restoring regulating services in order to elicit a general improvement of regulation and supply systems because we improve eco services. Some attempts have been done in Great Britain, and apparently in Great Britain it would be advantageous to moderate agricultural production and restore ecosystems. The economic stakes with the restoration of ecosystemic services and promotion of green species would take precedence over the increase in agricultural production. This can only be achieved if we retribute people who directly depend from ecosystems, and this would be what we call payment for ecosystemic services. The experiment is quite spectacular, and the town of Beijing also has conducted a spectacular experiment. The water in Beijing was no longer drinkable, and now the farmers in the catchment area around Beijing are being retributed in order to protect ecosystem functionalities, this for the benefit of town dwellers, people living in the town of Beijing, because now they have better water, but also for the benefit of farmers, because farmers can have an additional income while developing a kind of activity which socially is more interesting. They find a better compromise between agricultural production and regulating services. In conclusion, the take-home message will be that the ecosystemic service notion is at the heart of the problem. It provides a new vision on the way we manage ecosystems, and by preserving regulating ecosystemic services, we will preserve biodiversity, because biodiversity is preferentially associated with ecosystems that are rich in regulating services.